Hey everybody, it's Jack from The Modern Coder, and I'm back again with another Git video, and this time it is a highly requested one, and that is how to use Git cherry pick. And in this video, I'm going to be showing the actual commands required plus live animations right above my head of what's happening to the Git tree under the hood while all of the commands are being issued. Now, I guarantee this will not only demystify cherry pick for you, but this tutorial will stick in your mind. And if you don't believe me, ask the thousands of other folks who have benefited from these types of explanations in my other Git videos. So let's do it. Cherry picking means choosing a commit from one branch and applying it to another. To be more exact, cherry pick applies the changes introduced by one or more existing commits onto another branch. Now, cherry pick is similar to git merge and git rebase, but rather than taking an entire branch worth of commits or sort of moving commits around like you would do with merge or rebase, cherry pick allows you to apply only the changes that you want to apply. All right, now let's talk about cherry picking in practice and the actual commands needed to get it done. So let's say I'm working on a web application with another engineer. So I have a repository checked out and it looks like this. Now, as you can see, that white branch is our main line and the blue is another branch that my coworker started to work on the navigation. Now, if I populate the actual commit messages, you can see that my coworker actually fixed a bug on their branch before starting to work on the navigational components. Now I'm working on mainline and I want to grab that bug fix without taking any of their other unfinished changes. Now this is where cherry pick comes in and is the right tool. In order to use cherry pick, you need to refer to commits by their commit hash, or in other words, the unique ID of the commit that you want to cherry pick. Now to get those actual unique identifiers, I can run git log. Now if I just run a regular git log, it's just going to show me the commits from the branch I'm on. Now, I want to see the commits from my coworker's branch. So I'm just going to run git log and then specify the branch I want to see commits for. And I'm actually going to use the one line option just to make it a little bit more readable. Now, here is all the commits on the nav branch. On the left is going to be the unique identifying hashes of each commit. And you can see my bug fix commit is right here. Now, I want to pull that on. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that hash. All right, with that hash code, we have all that we need to run cherry pick. Now you want to make sure that you have the branch that you want that cherry picked commit to move onto to be checked out. So you can see I have main checked out, it's in my prompt, but you can also run git status and you'll be able to see what branch you're on. And if you don't need to, you can just git check out your branch. Okay, so to run cherry pick, we're going to run git cherry pick followed by that hash code of the commit that we want to grab. Now when I run this command, what git is actually doing is it's applying the changes introduced by that bug fix commit onto the mainline branch and actually creating a new commit with all those changes. Now you can see this if I run git log and compare that with the hash code of the nav branch's bug fix commit, that they are different hashes. But wait, what about multiple commits? Well, cherry pick can do that too. So let's roll it back and say I not only want to grab that bug fix, but we can see that my coworker added a new logo for the site. Now, if I wanted to grab both of those without taking any of those other in progress changes, I can do that with cherry pick as well, and the process is similar. So to cherry pick multiple commits, we're just going to need the unique identifier of each of those commit hashes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to once again run git log, and I'm going to figure out those hashes from the nav branch. Now, as you can see here, the logo is in this commit and then the bug fix is in this one. So I'm just going to grab both of those hash codes, run git cherry pick, and then grab those two hashes and enter. What's going on under the hood is git is applying the changes introduced by those commits one at a time in the order that they were specified in the cherry pick command. So in this case, I added the hash of the logo change first, followed by the hash of the bug fix commit second. So git is going to apply those in that order. And at the end of the day, we're going to end up with actually two new commits that contain those changes. If the changes introduced in those commits that were cherry picked sort of have conflicts with what I already have on mainline, or if I was already working on those files that were also touched by that bug fix commit, I'm going to have a problem. I'm going to have a merge conflict. And I know that can get a little bit confusing, but I'm going to show you how to fix those right in this video. And don't worry, the video gets straight to the point. The only reason I separated the two of these videos is just because if some people are looking for actual advice on how to fix merge conflicts and cherry pick, I didn't want to have them watch this whole video just to get to that part. In any case, click that video and I'll explain how to deal with any merge conflict that could come up while you're using cherry pick. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later.